Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I am here with a Project Use It Up box. I'm going to give myself a realistic timeline to use these by because every time I tried to do it before, I would rush myself to finish them and then I wound up burning myself out on the scents. Although these are not seasonal, these are just older things that I really need to use up before they wind up going bad. Today is March 14th. I'm going to give myself until Memorial Day, which is May 28th. So that gives me like almost 2.5 months to get this stuff used up. Again, before when I burned myself out, it was more seasonal stuff. It was like pumpkin stuff or winter stuff. And so this is just stuff that is older. I have a ton of and I need to just not have so much of the same scent or is older and needs to be used up before it no longer smells. So that being said, I have my box filled. Every week when I do my What I Melted videos, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to keep these separate, and then every week I will do my progress on that. And then once a month or so when I do my monthly empties or something. No, because that one's too busy. Once a month or so, I will do an update as to what I have left. So this one will be my beginning video, so you guys know what I started with. And then I will do a progress update video once a month. And then at the end, I will do what I have left. And I will link this video with that one so you can see what I started with what I ended with. So I'm just going to jump right in because there's a lot of stuff. There's a lot of most of it's Super Tarts. I think all of it, honestly, is Super Tarts and VCS. So, yeah. So the first thing I have is Go to Sleep and Magically Delicious. This I had gotten in a trade with my friend Rebecca. I got a bunch of stuff from her, and so you know, there's just a few BAM pieces or clam shell cubes or whatever. So I'd like to finish most of these up by then because I don't know the age of them. I know some of these came out approaching a year ago because I know she's been buying for a year. And I know a lot of these came out in the spring of last year or summer of last year, and there's no need to hold on to them forever. So I'm going to go ahead and work on finishing these up. The next one is Sand Dollar Cookies. And I have a BAM bag coming in this because I ordered it in the pre-order. And I have like 2 clamshells, so I really should finish this up. The next one is Mini Bows. Again, I have a clamshell and I have a whole BAM bag in this, so I'm going to finish that up. Get Out of the Water. There's 3 clamshell pieces. I bought this one in a de-stash, and I just have several clams of this, so I'm just going to work on finishing that up. Doomsday, there's only 2 clam cubes left, and this one I have another that's almost full that I got in an REOK, and by May I'm going to be wanting to do tea and that kind of stuff anyway, so that's a perfect timing. These, I don't even know how old they are. I know these are super old because as long as I've been in the wax game, she's used the newer style scent shots. So these I have to use. The first one is Rocket, and these are the old style scent shots. And Green Goblin. And then I have some BAM bags. I went through my BAM bags because I got my 3 new ones from the Harry Potter collection in, and I could not fit them in the bin. So I had to take some out to fit those in. And I have 3 more coming in the next 4 to 6 weeks from the opening she just did. So I took a whole bunch out that were from last spring or only had a handful of pieces left, and I'm going to work through those. This one I had actually just bought in a de-stash, and it's a Mary Mouse. And there's just 2 cubes left. I have a full BAM bag in this, so I'm wanting to finish that up. And then these are the ones that I have that are my own. The first one's Casper. And there's, 2, 4, 6, 7 pieces left in this one. And I have, like, 5 clamshells. So I'm wanting to finish that up. The next one is Aria. And this is one of the very first band bags I ever bought. This was from probably April or May of last year. So we're talking almost a year old. And there's 5 pieces left in that one. The next one is Coven. This one was from Wax Wednesday, but I have a whole nother band bag, so I'm really wanting to finish this one up. And this one has 7 pieces. My allergies are killing me today. It is like spring, so like I am so stuffy. It's not even funny. The next one is Jackal, and I have another band bag, and I have a half pan in this, so I'm like no danger of running out. And there's 5 pieces left in this. The next one is Immortal Child, and I have a whole pan of this one, so I'm trying to finish this up. And there's 9 pieces left in this one. So this one will take me a while. I may not finish that by the end because I only melt bedtime blends in one warmer a day, and I'm not going to melt the same thing, you know, more than once or twice a week. So that one I may just put them in other, if I get down to 1 or 2, I may put them in other warmers in the house. I'm sorry, I'm so tired. It's spring break, but I am exhausted. I don't know why, because my kids aren't in school this week, so I'm not getting up early. The next one is Poltergeist, and this one I don't necessarily care if I finish this one or not, but I want to make a good dent in it because I have a whole nother band bag, and this one's about half full. So again, I don't really want to finish it per se. I just really want to get a good dent. And the last one is Mama's Family. This was from April of 2017. If you can, yeah. And so there's several pieces in that one. So most of those I'd like to finish. The ones that have less than 10 cubes left, I'd like to finish. The rest, I'm not really overly caring about finishing them, but I do want to make a good dent. So now on to VCS. All of these VCS scents are from either 2015 or 2016. And so I'd like to just get these finished up before they wind up not, you know, smelling as good. I know the stuff I have melted from 2015 still throws beautifully, but I don't want to take my chances with too much longer. So I'm just going to jump right in. These are in no particular order. They are not in any sort of date order, name order, anything. Let's see. All right. Grandma Mackinson's Blackberry Patch, and this one was from May 8th of 15, and it is a rose. What I've been doing with these is I have been cutting these in quarters and just melting the whole thing at once. I do a quarter in my bedroom, a quarter in the living room, a quarter in my office, and a quarter in the dining room, just to do it all in one swoop, because these are these flip-top bags. I don't like these. I'm so glad she switched sometime in like late 2016, I think, because half of my 2016 wax has the flip top, and then half my 2016 wax has the zipper bags. So she switched it sometime, either late 2016, early 2017, and just put everything in the zip top bags. So these flip over bags, I don't trust, especially from 2015. If I open this, I have a bad feeling that it's not going to last. I don't want to rebag a half a rose because that wastes the bag. So I'm just throwing the whole thing at once. I've done that twice this week. It's worked out very nice. These have been giving me a very good throw. They're not as long lasting as most VCS, but at almost 3 years old, I really don't expect them to last too terribly long. I do probably get between 4 and 6 hours out of them before I can't smell them anymore. So, so that's one. Another one is Forget About It. And this one's from June of 2015. That's another rose. And then I have Mayfair, and this is from July of 2016. And this one's going to be good. I'm going to save this one for May because we're going to be getting into the wanting to have all the overly fruity scents. And then I have a couple of loaf chunks in Pink Dorothy, and this is from July of 2016. So when I'm done with these little things, this is all my 2016 and 2015 small things. When I'm done with these, I'm going to work on my bigger things. I have a couple blossom bags, and I have some loaves that are from mid to late 2016. So once these are gone, then I will work on finishing up those, because then I have the 2017 stuff I want to work on. So I have a method to my madness to keep it so that I don't use things that are too new. And that's why I am using the older things first. Trying to keep a hinge on it so I'm not wasting the wax that I've paid good money for and she's poured. So the next thing is Beehive. And this is from July of 2016. And this is one of my favorite scents. Y'all know that. And I purposely bought these. The 2015 ones, I purposely bought. Because I wanted to see how well older wax performed. And I got a really good deal on it. So I did buy these purposely, knowing they were old. I just bought these ones from 2015. I just bought like a month or two ago. A lady had a bunch of lots she sold. The next one is State Fair, and this is from October of 2015. This one I'm not even sure I'm going to like because I think it's got cinnamon in it, but I'm still going to melt it. Imogene's Lavender Supreme. This is from 2-9 of 16. This is just one bedtime melt, so that will be gone in one day. Betty Page. This is one of those flip-top bags. I hate it. I really hate it. They don't stick as well. I know the wax I had from 2016 that was in these, the 3-pack coins before she moved to the 4-pack coins and did the zip top bags, did not throw as well. And I think it's because of the bags. So this is a coin and then a quarter of a coin. So those I will finish up. This one I actually rebagged, Lucky Luciano. This one was in a flip top bag. I could not get it to resale, so I just rebagged it. And there's just 2 coins there. Princess of Wales, there's a coin and a half, so that one I will definitely finish. Whoops. Jackie O and Callie, this one I will probably work on towards the end of this project because it is a very fruity scent and I'll be into fruity stuff about summertime. This one I don't care if I don't finish, but I'd like to get a good dent in it. It's Jenny and the Pink Ladies, Charade, and Carousel. There's a lot going on. It's Petite Fours, Whipped Cream, Pink Sands, Pink Chiffon, Fawn, cotton candy frosting, vanilla waffle cone. So there's 3 of the big medallions, a coin, and then 2 small shapes. So are those 2 big medallions, 2 coins, and 2 small shapes. So I would like to at least get half of this done. I don't care if I don't finish it, but I do want to get down to 1 of each of the shapes. Hi, Bubba. I'm not going to yell at you because I get in trouble if I do. Yeah, you got wild eyes this morning. The next is Sugar Sugar. This is from May of 16. This came in that same de-stash with those 2015 things. Look how cute these are. They are like little baby loaves. Of course, I shed all over the place. Look at the strawberries on top. They're so cute. So this I'll probably cut into either like 3 pieces or 4 pieces and get that done. Oh, I'm so stuffy. Cindy Lou Who. This one's from December. I'm not as overly concerned about finishing it, but if I do run out of stuff, I will work on it. I don't care. This one's one I can, move off into the next one. This is that Cranberry Ginger Ale. So this one's kind of like, it's not old enough that I'm going to really care, but this one and Princess of Wales, these two are from late 2016, so I don't care if I don't finish them. They're going to be at the bottom of the box in case I don't get around to them. I'm not going to cry about it. But the ones that are from 2015 and then early to mid 2016, I would like to finish. The next one's Princess of Wales, and this one's from April of 2016. And then Million Dollar Mermaid, and this is from August of 2016. I love this scent. It's fresh ocean water, sea berries, bergamot, white musk. This one I will probably do towards the end of it as well, just because it is kind of summery. Another Jackie O and Callie. Jackie O's Milk Glass. This is from August of 2016. Beautiful Jackie O Loves Fall. And this is a nice, this will be a nice one for on a weekend morning. There's a lot of like breakfast foods in that. Jackie O's Pearls. And these are all from August of 2016. This one's another one I don't care if I don't finish. It's Strawberry Jackie O. It's from November, so I'm okay. I'm going to put this in the pile to put at the bottom. If I don't finish it, I don't care. I want to have enough just in case I do happen to melt through all this, because if I have a Project Use It Up box, I tend to reach for those things first. So if I do that, then I wind up finishing things fairly quickly, because if I'm giving myself 2.5 months, I can get through all of this or most of it. So the next one is Jackie O Supreme, and I actually have two of those from that vintage. This one I don't care if I don't finish either. It's Bourbon Orleans Hotel, and this is from October. I may save this for this coming like September. It's Cider Lane Pumpkin Cupcake Marshmallow Birthday Cake Vanilla Bean Noel. I have 2 4-packs of this, so I wanted to kind of work on this one, but honestly, it's not old enough for me to be like panicking and caring about it. Here's another Jackie O's milk glass. And the last thing I have here is another Jackie O's pearls. And so these also from August, I'm not overly concerned about finishing, but I would like to get working on them. I'd like to, because there's 3 of each, except for this one. This one I only had one of, but I have 2 of the Jackie O Supreme, 2 of the Jackie O Milk Glass, and 2 of the Jackie O's Pearls. I would like to, while I'm on the books talking about this, I would like to melt at least one of the ones I have double of. So since I have 2, if I end this with 1 of each, that's great. I'll put it in my summer project Use It Up box. But if I get through both, great, but I only care about really getting through one of each of these that I have double of. So yeah, I have quite a bit of wax here I want to work on. So it'll be mostly a Super Tarts and VCS in the next couple months. I do have my standard bedtime melts and my standard bathroom melts and my standard coffee melts. So you'll still see some regular stuff, but I'm gonna really push through and work on getting these going and getting these melted. So yeah, I mean, I spent the entire weekend after my in-laws left, because I had gotten so many packages, I'm like, where the hell am I gonna put this stuff? So I spent the entire, they left on Saturday morning, I spent Saturday afternoon and evening, I don't think I worked on it much on Sunday, but I spent most of Saturday organizing my bins, taking out stuff I'm not going to use and destashing it, taking out stuff I have too much of and destashing it, and then putting together this box, my Project Use It Up box, so that way I could reach for these things instead of reaching for other things or not knowing what to reach for. If I have a Project Use It Up box, I like to know that I can use these at my own leisure. But then I also have a good variety to work with. So again, you'll see regular melts because I have my standard ones that I melt regularly that don't apply for this. They're not needing to be used up real quick, but I do have, so you're going to still see some variety. I'm not only going to be melting from this box. This is just stuff I really would like to finish up. I'm sorry, I keep yawning. I am exhausted. and while my kids are on break, I have to record when they are being quiet. So like we just woke up and they're upstairs being quiet. So I figured, okay, I'm going to get this done while y'all are being quiet. And they're like, okay. So anyways, I hope y'all enjoyed this video and I'll talk to y'all later. And also, I just noticed that I hit 500 subscribers last night. And I never thought in a million years I'd have 100, let alone 500. So that's super exciting. And thank you everybody for being here. And thank you for all the support on my other video. I only mentioned it because I had so many people who were truly upset about the way I spoke to my cat. But most of y'all don't seem that concerned. So I don't know where all the issue lies. It was mostly 2 people. They were just nasty about it. And the main reason why I deleted their comments was, one, my channel, I tend to have a positive atmosphere. I have the right to delete any comments I want. So I do delete all negative comments. 2, my daughter, who is 10, watches most of my videos. Yeah, I do cuss a lot. I cuss a lot at home around her. Cussing is no big deal. I did not want her reading the comments. So that's the other thing, is I did not want my child to read nasty comments about how I should have her and my animals taken away. So there was several reasons why I deleted the comments, because that would upset her if she read that. So I do have the right as the owner of the channel to do whatever I want. So yeah, I'm going to delete negativity. I'm going to block negativity. I'm not going to have it here. So if that's all you're here for, then, you know, I can show you the door. That's how I am. So most of you guys are supportive. Most of you guys are, you know, amazing, but there's a couple who follow me for the wrong reasons, and I don't care. If you want to follow me for the wrong reasons, go ahead, but just keep your comments to yourself. So, anyways, I just wanted to say thank you for the ones who supported me, and I cannot believe I hit 500 subscribers. And I think my first video was about this time a year ago. I think I finally am at a year. And so, I'm going to scroll back and see when my first video was, but I'm fairly certain it was the middle of March, because my in-laws went home around the 4th or 5th of March, and I think I recorded my first video, like, the next week. So, I may have already hit the year, but, oh well. So, anyways, I hope y'all enjoyed this video, and I'll talk to y'all later. Bye.